Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we will learn about plotting non-chronological data in a Vue chart with a category axis. Look at this column chart, which displays the gold medals won by different countries in the Olympic Games. Here, the column chart axis is enriched with elements like axis labels and axis range. Now, let me show you how to customize the category axis. I open an existing Vue application, where I have already added the Vue Charts component. I have imported the chart plugin from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Charts package and registered it globally inside the API Vue.use to register all child directives globally. If you would like to know how to create a Vue app and add Syncfusion components to it, click the video link in the card above. You can also find a reference link in the description below. I save the application and run it with the command npm run serve. Here, you can see the default chart output with two axes, X and Y, with no data points displayed. Next, I will show you how to add a category axis to the Vue chart. First, I need to define an E-series definition inside the E-series collection tag. I plan to display column chart, so let me import the column series from the Syncfusion Vue Charts package and inject it in the provide option. Then, I set chart series type as column. I populate the data in the chart by creating an object variable, chartData, and assigning an array of objects with two fields named country and value within this data method. Then, I assign this object to the datasource property and map the datasource fields country to the xName property and value to the yName property of the chart. Notice here, I have bound categorized country name data in the x-axis, so I need to customize the x-axis value to be category in order to display the medal counts by country in the chart. To use a category axis, first, I import the category module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Charts package and inject it in the provide option. Then, I define the variable chart primary x-axis and set the value type property to category. I assign this variable to the primary x-axis property. Then, I define a variable chart title and set the title to Olympic medals. Now, I assign this variable to the title property. You can see the column chart with the categorized x-axis, displaying the appropriate labels USA, Great Britain, and so on, and the main title of Olympic medals. Okay, now let me set the titles for the chart axes to enhance the chart's readability. To set the title for the x-axis, I define a title property and set its value to country. For the y-axis, first I define a variable chart primary y-axis, and then set the title with the value medals count. I assign this variable to the primary y-axis property. See the chart output with the x-axis title country and the y-axis title medals count. Next, let's look into the category axis properties one by one with simple scenarios. In the chart output, based on the index value of the data source, the data items are shown in the chart. So, the index value 0 represents USA, 1 represents Great Britain, and so on. To show the data items from Great Britain to India, we need to set a custom range. To set the custom range, let me add two options, minimum and maximum, within the chart primary x-axis variable. For these options, we can set any of the index values from the data source. So here, I set the minimum range to 1 and the maximum range to 5. Now, you can view the chart output with the custom range that displays the data items from Great Britain to India. Like the minimum and maximum, a custom interval can also be set for the x-axis. The default interval is usually set to 1 so that the chart displays all the data items from Great Britain to India. Suppose I set the interval as 2 for the x-axis. Then, the chart skips a few data labels between Great Britain and India. Here, you can see only the alternating data items on the chart like Great Britain, United Kingdom, and India. Next, let's see another important property, label placement. With it, you can place labels either between the ticks or exactly on the ticks. By default, the labels in the chart axis will be placed between the ticks as shown. If I want to place the axis labels on the ticks, I set the label placement property as on ticks within the chart primary x-axis variable. Viewing the chart output now, you can see the axis labels are displayed exactly on the ticks. Alright, lastly, I am going to show you how to add an indexed category axis to render the data points based on the exact index value of the data source. With the current data source, it is not possible to do this, so let's consider two different data sets to display the column chart with an indexed category axis. First, I remove the existing data source and its related properties. Along with this, I also remove the X and Y axis properties and chart title. Then, I define two different data sets that compare the growth rate of countries. I add one more chart series tag and set its series type to column. Now, I define two variables, weather report 1 and weather report 2, with data source fields. Then, I bind these data sets to their data source properties and map the data source fields country to the X name property and temperature to the Y name property. Before setting the indexed category axis, let me show you the chart output with the two different data sources. Here, you can see two column series rendered one after the other. Now, I enable the indexed category axis by setting the isIndexed property to true. Let's view the chart output now with the indexed category axis that shows the data items based on the index values of the data sources. In this video, we have seen how to categorize the x-axis of a Vue chart by customizing its value type, how to position labels for ticks, and finally, how to add the indexed category axis. If you would like to see a working example from this video, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Vue component suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.